I want to see if I can document the extent of human suffering to where people are willing to risk their lives to seek refuge elsewhere. And I'm devastated.
So that's a clip from a new documentary called America's Forgotten. It's focused on a subject that often gets brushed under the rug, at least in recent years, illegal immigration. In her latest documentary, director Namrata Singh Gujral sheds light on the harsh realities of illegal immigration and attempts to show the devastating truth about what the journey across the border really looks like. Namrata joins us live now, and we appreciate her being with us this morning. Our panel of the day is also standing by for reaction as well. And Namrata, just start, if you will, by talking a little bit about the film and what you've kind of discovered when you made it.
Thank you so much for having me, Newsmax. I actually started the picture last year. I am, as I've mentioned on a few other channels, I'm a registered Democrat. I started the picture with a very pro-caravan, pro-illegal immigrant standpoint. I wanted to document, as you just showed in the clip, I wanted to show the persecution and the poverty or the violence or whatever those extreme circumstances are that would have a parent, a mother or father, take their little children and flee their country to come to our borders and make that horrible trek, which takes you through several different countries before you get here, and it's not an easy trek. During the course of making the picture and through the investigations that we did, which was throughout the world, we traveled the world making this picture, I actually did an about pivot on my stance on illegal immigration, and I'm now probably the most anti-illegal person in the world because in the Democrat Party, we talk about being humanitarian. And I think if we're gonna be humanitarian, then we truly need to understand an issue and understand that illegal immigration doesn't really serve anyone. We lose lives, guys. This is not, it's not just about the money or about the jobs. We lose lives, not only American citizens at the behest of some illegal immigrants because we don't do criminal record checks, but a lot of migrants coming here lose their lives on the border because and before the border, coming from their various home countries to that track. And we just lose lives that we never even know that we've lost. Wow. From a humanitarian standpoint, we need to stop illegal immigration.
And what a revelation that you personally came to through this filmmaking process. Esther, you know, it kind of makes you wonder if you haven't seen the film, if perhaps you would have these automatic assumptions as to how different parties, political parties, would view the issue of illegal immigration and who would really be the victim in these circumstances. Again, they might not realize that, you know, certain parties don't have people's best interests at heart.
That's precisely right. And unless somebody watches a documentary such as Ms. Gujral's documentary, they will not know what I know as an immigration attorney actually know. The toll of human suffering and the illegal immigration only serves to benefit the drug cartels, the human trafficking rings, and the Democratic Party by bringing in fresh voters that are unaware of our constitutional laws and our system of governance. The real human toll is adequately addressed in this documentary. I urge everybody to watch it because it's showing who is really most vulnerable and who's getting hurt. Women and children at the hands of drug traffickers who are sold repeatedly over and over because it's easier to traffic a woman and a child than it is to get meth and fentanyl over the border, especially right now with the border closures. I think if people actually saw the true human suffering, they would understand that the Democratic platform towards illegal immigration and having open borders actually hurts and harms the very people that they're advocating to protect.
What's interesting too is in 2016, the president, President Trump, then candidate Trump, ran on policies very firmly against illegal immigration. And Lauren, I'm wondering how much of a role immigration really comes into play during this political cycle.
I think you make a great point, Emma, and that's that illegal immigration was a cornerstone of President Trump's 2016 campaign. What he emphasized, of course, was illegal immigrants coming over, taking advantage of social services or, you know, government-funded programs, taking American jobs. But this human trafficking story is a rare valence issue that most people agree on. The impact of this is something that the Trump White House has emphasized from time to time, but not consistently. And I do think they would have more widespread support among the public if that was the driving force behind the immigration policies, not necessarily the frames that were used on the campaign trail.
Namrata, I see you shaking your head. Just share final thoughts and, again, where we could see this film.
My final thoughts are that if you're a Democrat out there and you're still on the fence, please either watch this documentary or go learn the statistics. My idea is not to incite people, but my idea is to educate people before you vote on November 3rd. I don't think where the Democratic Party is right now with the far left strategies on illegal immigration is a good idea, and I'm not going to be voting for Joe Biden. I'm actually going to go ahead and vote for Donald Trump, which I never thought I would say in a million years. But you can certainly watch the film at go to americasforgottenmovie.com. And there's various different channels, and you can pick your channel and you can watch it. And I appreciate the support.
All right. We appreciate you coming on our program today and talking all about it. Namrata, thank you very much. Esther and Lauren, stick around. Still, we've got one more topic to get to.